So we've seen that the bioefficacy is the same between the sources. And also, we mentioned at the beginning of the webinar that hydroxymethionine has additional value beyond performance. And it's not only for protein deposition, but there is a valuable outcome for the feed producer. So I propose to focus the next part on these additional benefits. And Yves, maybe you can start and share with us one of the specificity of hydroxymethionine that can be of interest for feed producer.
Yeah, in fact, we are talking for minutes now around methionine. But in fact, as Dolores said, animals need total sulfur amino acids, and which is important is methionine, but also cysteine and other sulfur compounds, which are really important for growth and other function for the cell. Back to 2006, what we get, in fact, with a published paper by Dr. Raquel Martin-Venegas, it was that the HMTBA was more transsulfurated and giving more taurine and cysteine compared to DLM.
What is the interest to get seeing more of these compounds?
In fact, first point is that animal diets are, in general, deficient in methionine, but also in cysteine. And cysteine is really needed for protein synthesis. But also cysteine, have another advantage, is a precursor of other molecules like glutathione or like taurine, which are well known to be really involved in the antioxidants process within the cells. And by obtaining more of these compounds, in fact, we can have a better redox status for the cell.
And in which condition this enhanced redox status is interesting for the animal performance?
In fact, there is many conditions where the heat stress is rising, and maybe one of them most known is the heat stress condition, where there is a loss of performance. But one part is due to the decrease in feed intake, but a part is also due to the increase and the rise of radical oxygen spaces. And we performed a study some years ago comparing methionine sources under heat stress condition, and we get that, in fact, the performance were improved by using HMTBA compared to DLM, and this effect can be attributed to a better redox balance, what we can see on the right part of the graph, considered by the reduced glutathione compared to the total glutathione, which is increased with the usage of HMTBA compared to DLM. And of course, increasing this ratio means a better redox status for the animal.
And the rest, to go further in this discussion, can you share with us some other advantages linked to the hydroxymethionine compared to DL methionine?
Yeah, we just heard an example for broilers, and here is another one in swine. We know, for example, that sows must be supplemented with enough nutrients in order to ensure better maternal health, reproductive performance, but also protein utilization. And there are plenty of studies that have demonstrated that particularly during the late gestation phase, sows must be given enough amino acids in order to help them to go through the lactation phase. So thanks to its absorption pathway, we did a trial with an increase of HMTBA and DL methionine. And we demonstrated that with HMTBA, we have an increase of fat, of protein and lactose in the milk. And as a consequence for that, suckling piglets have a higher body weight and were enhanced in their antioxidant status that will help them to cope with any oxidative stress that may happen during the post-weaning period, just like we heard from Yves for broilers, for example.
Thank you for this highlight. So, in fact, you show both of you that hydroxymethionine has really greater advantage and additional value compared to DL methionine in terms of performance during heat stress, or Dolores, what you mentioned, in terms of increased sow milk quality. So, really, there are a lot of value of this molecule. molecule and we are not at the end of the story. Other things will come. So now we are arriving at the end of this webinar. So I would like to thank you warmly, both Dolores Bâtonnant-Lalvo and Yves Mercier, for all this interesting light and discussion. And also, I encourage you behind your screen to ask questions to the email address feedchannel@feedchannel.online, and we will answer shortly. So I thank you, all of you, and you for watching, and stay tuned on Feed Channel. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.